rockeoperetter, kanskje. Give a big hand to Mr. John Martin. Oh. Is it always like this? Always, always. John Martin, take a good look at these people around here.
I see them, I see them.
Do you know that you could have been the father of most of them?
Well, there is every possibility. I did spend some time in Oslo around 14, 15 years ago.
Well, I don't say you are, but it's a fascinating idea. Grunnen til at jeg nevner det, the reason why I mention it is that some people in this country tend to believe that rock is a teeny bop thing. I feel that you don't agree.
Well, no, you'd have to ask Mick Jagger. He's 7 years older than me. He might know, you know. And then, of course, there's Jerry Lee Lewis. He's a real youngster.
You feel like a youngster.
I think so.
Ikke noe grunn til å spørre John Martin om dette med rock er en tenåringsaffære. Spør heller Mick Jagger eller Jerry Lee Lewis, sier han. I know that you made your first recording in 1968, and you made another recording in Woodstock. Hørte du det? Er det noen som gamle nok? they're kind of symbols for some of us. Does it still have influence on you that time?
No, I must be honest, I burned my caftan and threw away the beads. But I still believe in peace and love.
Tror fortsatt på kjærlighet og fred, men har kastet unna hippie-tingene. Okay, you plan to keep on rolling for some more years. And can you tell us a little bit, in very few words, what's the John Martin sound like in, let's say, year 2020?
Well, I think it might be a little harder, just a little harder, you know.
When the road is carry you on stage.
Okay.
Okay, han lover hardere toner når han stiller på scenen i år 2020. Vi glemmer fortiden og fremtiden, because...